The women's movement in India has lost three veteran visionary feminists within 1 month. Gay Lambert on 25th of August 2021, Sonal Shukla on 9th of September 2021, and Kamala Basin on 25th of September 2021. All these three veteran feminists bridged the gap between theory and action and actively supported Indian Association for Women's Studies. All of them were shapers of autonomous women's movement in India and believed in feminist principle of personal is political. They were inclusive public intellectuals as well as champions of women's rights movement who left a path-breaking legacy of intersectional feminist writings. They were committed to secular humanism and had a deep urge to reach out to all sections of society. Dr. Gay Lambert passed away at the age of 80, she was committed and courageous, prolific writer, powerful social scientist who brought to the fore Phule Ambedkar legacy in the context of rising social movements in the post-emergency period. Gail's close association with grassroots movements of rural, urban, and tribal women, farmers and forest dwellers, women-headed households, and her involvement in newly formed women's rights movement during the late 70s were captured in her engaging and outstanding first-person account in her book, We Shall Smash This Prison, published in 1978. She was a prolific writer, popularly known as a political theorist, who pioneered intersectional analysis of caste, class, and gender. Memorial meetings organized by rural groups, Dalit organizations, academic institutions, activists of grassroots movements, farmers' organizations, Bahujan groups, bears witness to the fact that Gail had made a permanent mark among the progressive thinkers and practitioners dedicated to social transformation. A veteran feminist activist and public intellectual, Sonal Shukla passed away on 9th September 2021. This has created an irreparable loss to women's rights movement. She was a powerful writer, orator, and debater who consistently championed the causes of girls and women's rights. Founding trustee of Vacha, a feminist resource center for girls and women, Sonal Shukla was a champion of feminist activism, gender-responsive cultural alternatives in terms of songs, posters, essays, films, and plays. She was always vociferous about women's rights right from her early childhood. Though through her writings and oratory, Sonal consistently highlighted burning issues of women at workplace, in the homes, in the political spheres. She was also humble and witty and warm. She had zest for life and was actively involved in solidarity work for local as well as global efforts of women's rights movement. Sonal was a great giver, lived for others. On 8th March 2021, she was awarded an icon of women's movement in India and across the globe award under the banner of Gender Icon Award instituted by Frederick Ebert Stiftung, India. On the same day, graphic novel penned by veteran feminist journalist Jyoti Punwani and illustrated by Sharad Sharma, capturing milestones of Sonal's life, was also released in social media for free download. Currently, this FES publication has gone viral. Kamala Basin left us on 25th September 2021. Her passing has caused an irreparable loss to the feminist movement and 1 billion rising movement in India and Asia. Kamala Di, as she was popularly known, lives in her songs, verses, stories, speeches, publications in multiple languages, and most importantly, in our hearts and minds. Thousands of scholars, activists, young adults with non-English background, ridiculed by their elite peers as vernacs, got their understanding of feminism by studying Kamala Basin's booklets of feminism, patriarchy, gender-based violence, so on and so forth. Kamala made discourses of women's rights accessible to the first generation learners by deprivatizing her intellectual and creative resources. Kamala became their window or a door or a pathway for feminist worldview. Kamala Basin was a founder member of Jaguri, Pacific and Asia Forum from 1985 to 1995, South Asia Women's Network, Aurat Foundation, and played a pivotal role in forging solidarity among feminist movements across the South Asian countries. In the last conference of Indian Association of Women's Studies at National Law University, Delhi, Kamala's speech brought to the fore heroism of women's rights movement and race slogan of protecting Constitution of India, and of course, her most popular slogan, Azadi, based in her spirited style, echoed the conference hall, lifted, and it also lifted everybody's spirit. In the month of May 2021, we had invited her as a chief guest to address international conference, but due to her medical investigation, she could not join. We had a long conversation on telephone, and in the midst of pain also, Kamala was so optimistic, and she gave energy to not only me, but thousands of women across South Asia. We pay our homage to these three gender icons on behalf of Population First and Lardy Media Award. Thank you.